We're now joined by Ed Francisco, BDO Capital. Good afternoon, Ed. Welcome to Market Edge.
Good afternoon, Stan.
Yes, fast figures first. We ended at 65.88. We're up just a little over 0.1%. Value turnover, 5 billion. Property was the biggest counter that lost almost or more than 2%. In fact, not the best figures to welcome or as a salvo for the bear months, don't you think?
Yeah. Although, seasonally, anyway, September is really not so good. So I'm not going to not put too much weight on that. Mm. I think even in the rest of the world, especially in the U.S., they're not expecting September to be a surprise in terms of positive news. So let's see. Let's just be. I guess manage our wealth and then watch carefully.
Okay, it's been projected to be flat for the rest of the week. We're in fact ending flat today, hovering just above 6,500. What catalysts do you see might keep that from going down further? And what sentiment prevailed to result in a third day of a weak finish?
Yeah. Well, catalysts to prevent it down further? Let's see. Because the major news we will be hoping to get is the, I guess, inflation numbers, right, will come out the next few days.
Right.
People are projecting 5.4 to 6.7. But if the inflation numbers are, I guess, on the low sixes, that might be a catalyst for people to buy. They'll see that as a good sign. But if the results are on the high side, then people will still be a little worried because that means that we'll probably have to increase rates further and try to slow down the economy. So other than that, there are no other major news that we're following. Mm-hmm. So it's really the rest of the world, what's happening in the other markets abroad.
Okay, now how possible is another breach? Because a lot of people are uncomfortable with the 6,500 level, actually. A breach of immediate support before the market is going to poise itself for another rally towards 7,000, which is what everyone's hoping for right now.
Yeah. No, of course, I like you, I'm hoping that it goes up faster already. I don't see it immediately going up. Maybe until we see the last, monetary board BSP hike, because the U.S. is still projecting an increase, and that's what's just giving me some caution. That might make the market still here a little choppy. So once that's done for the year, that's when I think bubulusok na yung market natin babaw.
And of course, that sense of aggressiveness globally can result in more bad news for the local markets. August inflation seen between, of course, 5.9 to 6.7, as you mentioned, still attributable to rising food costs. What is your forecast now for August inflation ahead of the official release next week?
Yeah, at least the BDO view, our house view, is at around 6.4. So if we get it at that or lower, I think that's already a very good sign that we have things in control. Of course, I was listening to you earlier with what's happening with Meralco and with SMC's Global Power, might increase power prices and that will increase our inflation. But that will happen, I guess, another month or so forward. But if those are resolved and fuel prices continue to go down, then at least we'll see lower inflation. So I'm hopeful, but I'm still guarded.
Okay, as long as we keep it below 6.4. Now, Ed, another thing to watch out for is weakness of the peso against the U.S. dollar, persisting with local currency approaching its 2004 levels of lows at 56.45. Now, how much of a concern is this, given that there is no let-up on Fed hikes? You said so yourself. Until the end of the year, they're going to be aggressive with remittance season still a month or two away. Will that even affect local currency against the U.S. dollar?
No, another good point, Stanley. One is because U.S. inflation is still targeted at around 8%. So I agree with you, we do not see a let-up in the Fed increasing the rates. And when they increase the rates, and if we don't match it, then of course our peso is likely to depreciate. So that's a big concern. But then I guess the government, our local government anyway, is more concerned with managing inflation than really managing the FX rate, which I agree with. So what that means is that we can see the peso depreciating further, But then in terms of remittances, because our loyal kapabayans and it will continue to remit, and of course it seasonally strengthens the dollar, the peso against the dollar, so that will hopefully keep it from reaching 56.50, 57, and then hopefully it will go back to the low 55, high 55s by end of the year's time.
Okay, lastly, Ed, corporate stories now. ABS-CBN and TV5 mutually agreed to terminate their 4 billion peso investment deal. There was a voluntary trading halt for ABS-CBN and ABS-CBN preferred stocks today as a result. Now, what sense do you make out of this development?
Yeah. No, my personal view is sayang, because I know how much work both parties put in. It would have been good for at least for the consumers and the industry. Mm-hmm. But I guess I just hear that I guess there were other concerns that were beyond the deal, beyond the numbers, that caused both parties to permanently to stop it. Too bad, but maybe in the future, in another form or that's acceptable to regulators and the rest, sana it can be resurrected, because it would be good for the economy and for the consumers.
All right. Thanks a lot for your insights, Mr. Ed Francisco, BDO Capital. Thanks a lot for your market guidance. Have a good day, sir.
Thank you, Stanley. Bye-bye.